so done with, done with. Why is coding so hard to learn? And does it get easier? All these amazing engineering leaders seem to have it all figured out. Are they just geniuses, or what is the secret? Oh geez, okay, let's just, you know. Today I'm going to be covering with you why exactly when you are first learning how to code, it can feel so difficult, so challenging. And of course, learning anything new comes with a lot of challenges, but for some reason, when we are learning how to code, whether it be your first programming language, or even if you've been a software engineer for quite some time, I mean, it definitely gets easier with time. There is hope for you that is just starting out. But why is it so hard to grasp? And I want to share with you today my thoughts around it. Okay. Also, can you believe in literally less than one week, actually in a few days, the Interact conference is happening, which I am so excited about. I'm curious to know who has signed up for it. As you know, it's a completely free virtual conference that is happening on October 25th. This is a conference I went to last year, and I still keep in touch with a lot of the speakers that were there. They are engineering leaders. They have some amazing advice to give. I felt like I took away from the conference a lot of insight, a lot of knowledge, but honestly, most importantly, in my opinion, is a lot of inspiration in how I can grow my career. So whether you are just starting out in your tech career or you are an engineering leader yourself, there is so much value that you will gain from this conference. Some of the panel topics include connecting your dev team's work to the business bottom line, being a leader in uncertain times, how to treat devs like human beings, and the science of building products for emerging industries. Also, you know we all love this part of conferences, which is giveaways. There are going to be a ton of different giveaways here, lots of prizes, and also too, there's going to be a live event chat so you can connect with others that are attending the conference or other speakers, and make sure to come say hi to me. There are going to be some incredible engineering leaders speaking at this event. Some of them include Rukmini Reddy, who is the SVP of Platform Engineering, Smruti Patel, who is the Head of Engineering, and Charity Majors, who is the CTO and co-founder. Now, this is just listing a few. There are so many others that you can connect with, which is really exciting. So if you haven't already, click the link down below my bio. It's completely free, happening in a few days, and leave a comment if you will be attending so I can look out for you. Okay, let's get back into it. Okay, we're back now, back in action, and it's way more peaceful and quiet, just the way I like it. Let's get back to it though. Why is coding so hard to learn? I want to share with you a little story on this. When I first started learning how to code, I discovered there are different kind of waves you go throughout the learning to code process. At first, there's this terror, there's this fear, am I going to be able to do it? And you question yourself a lot. Then comes this almost honeymoon phase where you're taking coding tutorials and you're like, wow, this is amazing. Thinking of all the projects you can build, how you are going to be the next Mark Zuckerberg, and just take over the world. And it's just like this euphoric moment when you first start learning to code and are taking tutorials and everything's going pretty smoothly. You're telling your friends about it and they're all really impressed that you're gonna be a coder, it's really cool. And then you think, you know what, I've taken a few coding tutorials, let me try building something on my own. This is where that peak hits of that honeymoon and you start going downhill very quickly. Meaning you start building a project on your own and you quickly realize that, wow, this is a lot harder than when I was following a tutorial. And it's one of those things that you realize, I don't know as much as I thought I did. So then you start Google searching for other topics, searching for other ideas. Maybe you even end up in what is called, tutorial hell, which essentially is you just keep on doing tutorial after tutorial. This point usually comes after the honeymoon phase when you should be focusing on building your own projects, but you just have that fear of the what if and the unknown, and maybe you've even tried to build projects on your own and just gotten stuck and didn't know where to go. Long story short, there's definitely highs and lows, and very high highs and very low lows when you are learning to code. The funny thing is, it's not just when you are starting to learn to code. It does get better as you get more experience because you have the toolkit to learn new things and learn them quicker. However, there definitely is times where you will still face imposter syndrome even 10, 20 years in and you pick up something new. It's way easier because you have that toolkit, but you still have those feelings. So going back to it, why is coding so hard to learn? I'm going to break it down to you as far as some of the reasons behind why it is. The first one is it's a new way of thinking for many people. And I can attest to myself who didn't pay attention in high school really to math or sciences. It just didn't seem quote unquote cool at the time. Now I wish I did. And no one really pushed me to. So in turn, I didn't have that side of my brain, that logic side of my brain that is used in programming. That wasn't a strong suit of mine to begin with. So as much as I was learning how to code, I was also learning how to think in a new way, how to problem solve in a new way. And I think that is something that a lot of people discover when they are starting out in their coding journey, is that this is a whole new way of thinking and problem solving. Another thing that happens way more often than not is that feeling of overwhelmed, kind of like I am in this rain right now trying to walk the dogs. But when you start learning to code or learning something new in tech, the first thing you will quickly realize is there is a lot to learn. There are so many resources out there, so much out there, and it's overwhelming. For me, I remember I would start learning, you know, React, and then Vue came out and I was like, or it was the hot thing at the time. It's like, oh my gosh, I need a switch. And you know, then something else came out and it's that feeling that you're never learning enough. And you are, first of all, learning enough. It's just, you need to take it day by day. And I think one of the most important things is whatever you pick, just stick to it until you feel pretty proficient in it. It's easy to jump around and then in turn, not really learn anything. Okay. Another reason why coding can be really difficult to learn is coding is hard to teach. And a lot of times you will be taking coding tutorials and maybe you really look up to these people, but they're not teaching it in the best way possible. Let me rewind that a bit. Maybe they're teaching it in the best way possible, but not in the way that works best for you. And I think half the battle is really finding someone, an instructor or a mentor, that can speak the way you understand, if that makes sense. Everyone learns so differently, some more visually than others. And at first, it takes a while getting used to what works best for you. For example, for me, when I started, I completely ignored the documentation. I was more a visual person. I wanted to see tutorials, see things moving on screen. And I do not recommend at all ignoring the documentation. That came to bite me in the butt later on. But the point is, whatever way that works best for you to start learning, do that. Even if it might not be the quote unquote correct way or the way people are suggesting, sometimes in order just to start something new, you need to do what you are comfortable with or what you know works best for you. And if you don't know what works best for you, that's also a part of the reason I think that a lot of people struggle with learning to code is because they're learning how to learn, which sounds kind of funny, but it really is a skill in itself. Another thing that happens more often than not is we learn too fast. When you go online, you see all these articles of how I became a full stack engineer in, you know, 2 months, or how I landed my first job in 2 weeks, or I don't know, just ridiculous things like that. And it puts subconsciously a lot of pressure on ourselves that we need to learn everything so quickly. But what that really does is we end up not learning anything because we don't learn anything well. Another thing that really didn't work well for me when I was first learning, and still to this day, I'm someone who needs to have support. And everyone's different. A lot of people, I've seen some incredible programmers who are self-taught and never had to ask another human a question, but just, you know, went on Stack, well, they asked another human, but they just went on Stack Overflow and asked that way. I am someone who, give me all of the support you got, let me, you know, take all your advice and insight. And when I was learning to code, I actually hired a mentor. I hired someone, a tutor, to sit down with me once a week. I was building a React project and I was actually working at the time as a software developer very early on in my career, but I was still learning React. I was working more in the back end side of things. And I was like, I just want someone who is an expert in the front end, is an expert with React, to sit down with me once a week and just like soak up all their knowledge. Now, maybe this isn't feasible for, you know, some people, and I'm not saying you have to go and spend your money on a mentor or a tutor. For me, it was completely an amazing investment because I learned so quickly so much information because I was able to have that one-on-one with someone who's an expert.
All right, let's talk about it. You know it's coming, this word that's so overused, imposter syndrome.
But it's true, it really can slow down your learning. A lot of times we question, are we good enough? Are we worth it? Am I skilled enough to learn this new thing? And it can really slow down your learning to the point where it almost freezes you, that you stop learning for a while because you think maybe this isn't for me. This is for you if you want it. And it takes time, as I mentioned earlier, it takes a lot of time. And it's one of those things that you just have to keep on repeating. It's like a muscle, I always say. The more you practice, the stronger you will get. Okay, those are some things that I think really, some insights into what makes coding difficult to learn. But at the end of the day, it's one of those things that I really believe anyone can do it, and maybe to varying degrees, depending on your background and things, but at least learn the basics, build some really interesting projects, and get a lot of value out of it. Also, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, show me some love and support. I love you all so much, and genuinely, I am so passionate about making videos to help you. And on that note, if there are videos you want me to cover, topics you want me to cover, leave in the comments. It's how I get my ideas of what you want to see, and I'll see you all soon. Thanks, everyone. Running from pain, running from strain, running from things, running from skin.